I've tried 100 different adult coloring apps today so that you don't have to waste your time and money. And today I'm revealing which apps were the best I found. Hello, I'm Sarah, and today I am taking on a different kind of coloring. Digital coloring using my iPad. I get a lot of questions about digital coloring, and it's something that I haven't really done much at all myself, but it is something that intrigues me. So today I decided it was time to put all of the digital coloring apps to the test to see which of them are actually worth downloading and to hopefully find out which are the best coloring apps for adults. All right, our first coloring app, relaxing adult coloring book, age 4+. So at a first glance, these don't really look like adult coloring pages. They're looking very, very simple. So I would actually say this is more aimed at kids so far. But look, we'll give them a chance and see what the functionality is like. Straight into an ad.
2 hours later.
A long ad. A very simple color palette. We can't use our stylus. I don't know what this is. Oh, you have to play another ad to access the other colors. Oh, look, the picture grows. So it's like a game that you have to unlock the rest of the picture. This is not what I'm looking for. So I've also created a little scorecard here so that we can actually compare them and see which of them have the best features. Happy color by numbers. This looks a little bit more promising already. We have a lot more intricate designs here that are aimed at adults. Oh no, this is color by numbers. It did say that. I wonder if you tapped the wrong... So you can't really get this wrong, even though they're really complicated images. I wonder if I can complete this whole page with my eyes closed. Challenge accepted. I didn't get very far. I've probably clicked that ad at the bottom of the screen by now, hey? No, we haven't clicked that ad. We're doing it. We haven't got very far though. Okay, so maybe I can't do it with my eyes closed. 75 different colors. So it is quite a complex image. I don't like that you can't control it yourself though, but look, this, I can see how this would be appealing to some people. Oh, done. Okay, what's next? Colorfy. Okay, this claims to be the number one coloring book with 25 million users. This app is good but bad. Interesting review. Try 7 days for free, then $11.50 a week. Can someone remind me in the comments to cancel all these, please? Okay, so we have a good variety of images, and there's even a 3D section here, which is quite interesting. Is this appealing to someone?
Oh, actually, this is, I like the color selection. This is a very simple color picker, and you can create your own color palettes. Oh, and here we go. You've got the full color wheel available. That is perfect. I love that. So we can fill. We can fill with a gradient. Not that you can see it.
Picked the wrong image to test this on.
How do I? Oh, we just tap.
I would love to see one where I can use the stylus and actually draw and blend. And I haven't come across that yet in any of these apps, but I'm sure we will find one if we keep looking. Now, this is interesting, the create section. So we can make our own mandala. Oh, here we go. This can be fun. Just go nuts. Maybe not like that.
So this mandala tool is pretty cool. I like that you can add shapes and then you can work off that.
This also has an import feature where you can take a photo of your own drawing and color it in. It's not great.
Finger paint mode.
That's what we've been looking for.
Oh, that's what I wanted. Yes.
So it turns out this little button at the top here changes the coloring mode you are in. So this does have a brush mode that will allow you to create the blends that I have been looking for. And it stays within the lines. Okay, back to our app store. Let's see what else we can find.
I'm starting to realize there are so many coloring apps.
Largest app image gallery, 5,000 images. Number one in over 60 countries on the App Store. The world's favorite adult coloring book with over 50 million downloads worldwide.
Ooh, these subscriptions are pricey. $150 a year.
This is the premium version though. So this is an app that comes with a free version.
Let's get started. Tutorial.
We don't need a tutorial. Or maybe we do. Okay, I already like the range of pictures we have here. We've got lots of variety. I like this. This looks like what I would expect from an adult coloring book app. We've got some inspiration from other people, and wow, there's some pretty cool stuff in here. Even just looking at what other people have created gives you an idea of some of the possibilities of this app. Like, wow, just look at the detail in this. That is amazing. So again, we've got a basic tap to color and different colors here. I like that they've included some unique gradients already. So you can go for a really inedible looking gingerbread house. Woo! Live colors, what does that mean? Oh, it's moving! You have to excuse my terrible color choices today. When I'm playing, I'm so not looking at how this actually looks. Okay, here is our paint with your finger option. But we can't change the size unless I'm missing something here. So far though, this app has actually given a lot more options than most, and I do think it is quite a fun one. Back to the App Store. Apple Design Award. Be kind to your mind. Why do they all want my money? Let's check out the free version first. Okay. New coloring journal. How's your day? Well, are we rating my day on how those coloring apps have been so far? Bored. Oh, finally an app that has brush sizes. So this app is almost more of like a fully inclusive mindfulness thing. They've given you a journal that you can put in and tell them how you're feeling. It creates a color palette based on your mood, and then you can use that color palette to actually color in a picture.
Whoa, lines opened. Whoa, now we can go over the lines.
Ah, very cool. And if we go lines closed, then it keeps it within the lines for us. I like that. So with the amount of coloring apps that I'm now discovering on the App Store, I am determined to try as many as I possibly can. But it's going to be unrealistic to try every feature of every single one and include all of them in a detailed blog post. So I'm going to try and narrow this down to a bit of a short list of the apps that I think that are actually worth exploring. And we'll put a little bit more attention into those later in this video. Oh, this is sideways. Okay, we're not. Turn on audio. Oh, I didn't even think about the sound effects.
Bring your favorite Disney characters to life with Disney Coloring World. Then play with any combination of them in one of the beautiful 3D play sets.
Wow. Let's go. Are you a grown up? Maybe.
Jasmine makes her own choices.
Would you like help coloring inside the lines?
No. Might regret that later. Oh, that feels like cheating though. That's just like the magic one. It just colors her exactly perfectly. Okay, now we can make a mess. I don't want to exit. Patterns. In the background. There we go. Pictures. Oh no, it just keeps adding them. I can't move them. There you go, have a lamp. Can you hold it? There, oh, it's a tiny lamp. There we go, that's better. She's holding a donut. Okay, what else we got? This is pretty cool for kids. I mean, it's pretty cool for us too. I'm enjoying myself. Oh no, we lost our donut. All right, one final touch.
All right, I think I've created quite the masterpiece right now.
Okay, adult coloring book and mandala. I click on vehicle and I get soccer. I can't click on, the categories are like messed up here. And those are clearly not adult coloring pages. Look at them. It's a bit awkward when the ad in your app is advertising a competing app. This is the first app that has shown the hex color and that we've got a lot more color options, which is really cool. This looks suspiciously similar to another app. The Pigment app has a huge variety of images, and I've used it about a year ago on this channel to import some of my own coloring pages and color them in. But before I go into the extra features, I've spotted something here that brings me back to the app we were just looking at, and I can't help but investigate. Okay, we have found our first copycat. Now, there is nothing wrong with taking ideas from different places when you create a product, but it's a little bit tacky when you take literal names of things to this degree. So I did think that I had seen these names before. So let's just have a comparison here.
So we've got Roller Rink. Vintage Sweater. Candy Store. Flower Basket.
We have Flower Basket.
Hummingbird,
maybe.
Soda Pop.
Toy Box.
Sunset.
Thrift Shop.
Rainbow.
Beach Time.
Tea Time.
After finding this suspicious color palette match, I discovered a multitude of other apps that were using the exact same palettes. And even worse, many that were completely identical apps, except the actual pictures sold under different developers. So I suspect someone has been offering a template app that many of these developers have bought. And this wouldn't bother me so much if these weren't all such expensive subscription models, and the use of the copied color palettes leaves me a little untrusting of these apps as a whole. So back to Pigment, this has galleries for inspiration, this has tutorials on how to actually use a lot of the features and how to create a lot of special effects. It has a huge variety of pictures that you can choose from, and you have an opportunity to actually post to the community gallery and get feedback from other people. So it does offer a lot more than a lot of the other apps that I've seen so far. They've got their own color palettes already in here, but they've also got such good color selecting tools, and you can enter hex codes. So this is where you can actually use the color catalog and set up your own color palettes and save them in here. In fact, here's one that I saved from a year ago, even though I have deleted and reinstalled this app since then. Even with your color palette selected, you can still darken and lighten the values of those individual colors, which is exactly how I like to use a color palette. So this for me is a really good workflow when it comes to colors. Down the side, we have brush size options here, and we have opacity options here. We've got a whole bunch of different brushes, so it's a little bit more of an art tool rather than some of these others that are just assuming that you're wanting to do a color by numbers or a drag and drop. There is still a fill tool to fill stuff really quickly that you can use with solid colors, with patterns, or with gradients to just fill areas super fast. Or you can use the brushes and lock the lines or turn the locking lines off and just color however you want. While the line assist might feel like cheating to some, I actually do like leaving it on because it allows you to spend more time focusing on the shading and getting those colors right rather than worrying the whole time about staying within the lines. Coloring book for me, adult drawing mandala games. The word games kind of makes me nervous that this isn't a serious thing. Okay, we've got lots of options here. Ooh, this looks interesting. I'm gonna make a photo of. That's just gonna be really hard to color now. Oh, if you tap it twice, it disappears. Okay, so we get some different color palettes. Pencil. Okay, we have our size and our opacity. Not bad. What else we got? A brush. Wet watercolor. That's not bad. Dry watercolor. Crayon. Spray. Sparkles. Filters. Texture. Social coloring.
Drag to fill multiple areas.
Done.
Oh, not with glitter. Oops, my bad. Subscribe, let's do it. Right, that turns on and off the lines. That's always good. Inspiration, here we go. This is what some other people have come up with. So this shows a bit of the capabilities of this.
There were hundreds of color by number apps in the store. So after realizing that the two or three I tried were the same, I decided not to include any in my results. These apps are fun, but they don't allow you to color outside the predefined areas or break the rules at all. So they are more like a puzzle than a coloring book. Traditional color by numbers still allows enough freedom for you to be creative, whereas these apps provided so many limitations that they didn't fit what I was looking for in my search today.
Coloring book now. Oh, look at that. We can color it with tinfoil. Is this the extent of my skill set now?
To the app store. Okay, what's next? With so many apps still to go through, I've decided to simplify my rating process for a quicker elimination. I've created two folders on my iPad to decide which apps are worth further investigation on my shortlist and which are an easy pass in today's comparison. In fact, I need to spare you what was a few more hours of downloading and testing out these 100 coloring apps, because while there were a lot of apps,
well, that just felt like a waste of time.
There were not a lot of good apps. I quickly began to notice patterns and trends amongst many of the app designs and features. It became really obvious that many of the developers had taken inspiration from each other or copied the larger and more popular apps rather than trying to take feedback from their users or cater to what the audience actually needed. Most of these apps seemed like a children's drag and drop coloring book, but with more complex images. They didn't include brushes, or they focused on fill-only options with gradients and fancy patterns. Many of them offered filters and fancy export options and social sharing, and quite a few had some kind of community, but the most common feature missing was what I would consider to be the most important feature for an adult coloring book over a children's coloring book, and that's a good brush with the ability to shade and blend. For the apps that included brushes, very few of them allowed you to even change the brush size, let alone the transparency. This was such a rare find in these apps, which really surprised me. And for me, a good brush proved to be far more important than the special effects, the filters, the import options, patterns, and even the color range. After trying exactly 100 different apps with over $550 in trial subscriptions to cancel, plus a few apps with broken subscription systems.
Did that just charge?
$65.
No. That said, 3-day trial. That just charged us $65 for this app. Instead of giving us a 3-day trial. That is bad. And they've stolen the color palettes again.
It's time to show you my favorites. From all of the apps I tried, I've chosen just 12 to take a closer look at. I've spent about an hour in each of these apps, exploring every feature and coloring a full page, and I'll break down the differences in detail in my blog post in the description so you can get a better look for yourself, including which apps are available for Android users too. These first few apps were fun, but did lack the brush features and blending abilities that I would like to see in an adult coloring book app. They were overall easy to use and had such good gradients and other features that I still wanted to give them an honorable mention in my final lineup, although they aren't quite my favorites today. You can find my detailed breakdown of these on the blog. InColor is a good app overall, but it lacks the ability to turn off the line assist that helps you color in the lines, which sounds okay, except some of the tiniest areas of the artwork became unfillable. Otherwise, I would have enjoyed this app a lot more. The Color app is quite different to the rest. First, it was the only app I found that was a one-off payment instead of a subscription, and it was also the only app to navigate like an actual book. This does mean you can't find your coloring pages quickly, but it provides a different coloring experience, and the range of coloring tools are really enjoyable to use. While it's different, I really liked this app overall. Lake is another unique app in that its focus is to create a mindfulness experience and a journal, and it does this really well. If you're looking for a general coloring app, I don't think this is it, because the color wheel is limited to more muted colors and the styles are very similar to each other. But if you're looking for an app to help you unwind, it's worth a look, because everything from the style of art to the color palettes are catered to this goal of mindfulness, and you'll be able to create beautiful artwork. I wasn't sure about including Calmeleon in my final lineup, but this app caught my attention as the only color by number app that I could find that allowed you to color manually. It includes some of the popular 1000 dot-to-dot books and the Quirkles coloring books, which are available as physical books as well. So while this wasn't an outstanding app on its own, I thought it was worth a mention. But it's time to show you my top favorites. Of the 100 apps I tried, there were just 5 that really fit the standard of coloring app that I was looking for when I set out on this mission today. Even these 5 apps have their room for improvement, but these were the apps that I was able to create the best art with without too much extra effort. So in no particular order, the first is Chroma. This app was one of the best I found and offered the cheapest subscription pricing out of my final 5 favorites. It had a great range of brushes and tools that were fully customizable, color palettes and the color wheel, a community to share your art and to inspire you, And you can import your own images as well. The one issue that I came across was that I misunderstood the purpose of the pigment liner. This is a brush intended for outlines, so it always sits on top of the other colors, which is actually kind of cool. I accidentally marked my work with it and wasn't able to undo far enough to fit it. So I ruined my final piece, but this was avoidable. So overall, this is a great app. Next is Recolor. This has over 4,000 images to choose from and is very easy for beginners. This is the only app in my top five that doesn't include adjustable brush sizes and transparency, but the standard brush works fairly well for creating smooth blends, so I was still able to create amazing art and didn't find this to be as much of a limitation as I expected. The overall experience is very simple, but allows for a lot of creativity and is a lot of fun to use. The community is huge and very active, and you can import your own pictures. The pricing is the most expensive out of the apps I tried, but the free version is very generous with the tools and the pictures that you can enjoy. Colorfly, not to be confused with Colorfy, is another great app with over 1,000 images, including a large range available in the free version. This app does have adjustable brushes and all the features you'd expect from a coloring app for adults, although it's more basic than some of the others in my top five. The one downside that I came across during my drawing was that the undo button would undo multiple brush strokes at once, and there was no redo button. So I found myself undoing a lot more than I wanted and unable to go back. Other than this, I was really happy with what I was able to create with this app. Now, you're probably not surprised to find Pigment on this list, but I wasn't sure how it would hold up against these other apps. So let's compare. Pigment has a range of over 6,000 images, the biggest range of all the apps. It includes an active community to share inspiration and give feedback, and you can import your own pages like I showed you in my previous videos a while back. The range of brushes available are more extensive than any other app I've seen, and they are fully customizable. There's also a variety of patterns, gradients, and fills that the other apps offer, along with the option to use the color palettes they've created or the color wheel. But there's one thing that Pigment has that none of these other apps have: hex codes. And not to take credit here, but I spoke to the team a year ago recommending that they add a hex code feature, because so many online color palettes use hex codes to help you recreate the exact same colors in your artwork, just like I do in my color catalog. And now the feature is here, so maybe I am taking credit. But this little feature means that you can import your own custom color palettes from the color catalog or Pinterest or anywhere else and save them here. And you just can't do that in other apps. So that is a big selling point for me. Thank you, Pigment, for listening. There's one final app on my list, and this one is for the Marvel fans out there. It's actually an app specific to Marvel that is made by the Pigment team. So you won't find florals or mandalas here, but you'll find all the licensed Marvel and Star Wars coloring pages that you can't get anywhere else. And because it's made by Pigment, you've got all those same great features to create something amazing. Well, almost. I have noticed that the color wheel has disappeared, but the range of available color palettes has also changed to be more suited to these kind of pages. So while I'm curious about this decision, I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing. Now, you might be wondering why I didn't include an app like Procreate in today's lineup. After all, you can import coloring pages into Procreate and create amazing art pieces without any limitations. Today, I chose to focus specifically on adult coloring book apps. Maybe in a future video, we'll look at art apps that you can also use if you want to really take your digital coloring to another level. Art apps will do that, but they also come with a greater learning curve, and they aren't primarily designed for coloring pages. So if that's something you'd like to see, please help me get the views up on this video by sharing it with your friends. Tell me your own experiences with digital coloring in the comments, and let me know if you found this comparison helpful. Remember, I've included even more information on the top 12 apps in my blog post that I'll link to below. For now, I need to go cancel some subscriptions and write to Apple to get a refund on that app that scammed me out of $65.